An operating system has to field external events. For example, external interrupts that may come in when a process is executing, or the process itself may incur some exceptions, such as a page fault, or it may make system calls. All of these are events that needs to be fielded by the operating system. And SPIN has to support such external events. And SPIN supports such external events using an event-based communication model. Services can register what are called event handlers with the SPIN event dispatcher. And SPIN supports several types of mapping. It supports a one-to-one mapping between an event and a handler. It also supports one-to-many mapping between an event and the handlers. And it also supports many-to-one mapping. Many events may map to the same handler. And let's look at concrete examples to illustrate the power of this mapping and how it might help in building system services. And what this picture is showing you is a typical protocol stack. And you may have several different interfaces available on your machine. And therefore, a network packet may arrive through one of several interfaces. Let's say you have an Ethernet interface and you have an ATM interface. A network packet may arrive on the Ethernet port or an ATM port. Those are events. And both of those may be IP packets, in which case there's an IP handler that needs to see the events. And so here is an example of many events mapping to the same handler. Ethernet packet arrival is an event, ATM packet arrival is an event, different events, but they map to the same handler, which is the IP handler. That's an example of many-to-one mapping. The processing of the packet by this IP handler results in an IP packet arrival event. And there may be several clients of the IP layer of the protocol stack. There may be a UDP transport, there may be a TCP transport, there may be an ICMP layer that are all sitting on top of this IP network layer. So when an IP packet arrival event is triggered by this handler, there are multiple clients for that. And this is an example of a one-to-many mapping, one event to multiple handlers that need to get triggered. And the SPIN dispatcher allows any number of handlers to be registered as handling a particular event type. And when that event type is raised, then all the handlers associated with that event type will get scheduled by the SPIN dispatcher. The order in which they get scheduled is not something that the designer can count on, because SPIN has freedom in the order in which these event handlers may get scheduled when a particular event arrives. But all the handlers that are associated with an event will get triggered when that event is raised. That's an example of one-to-many mapping. And finally, here is an example of a one-to-one mapping. If it's an ICMP packet, the ICMP handler processes the IP packet, and if it is an ICMP packet, then it raises an event that an ICMP packet has arrived. And maybe there is only one client for that particular event, and that may be the ping program, so that's a one-to-one mapping. Event handlers may also be specified with guards for finer grain handler execution. For example, this handler could specify that only when IP packets arrive, it should be executed. So that's a guard that the IP packet handler could specify, so that even though different kinds of packets may arrive on these interfaces, this handler will only get triggered when the packet that arrived on these different interfaces is an IP packet.